Use the treasure of repentance well. Keep the blessing of remorse in your soul, however late it has arrived. Don't forget that worrying doesn't solve our problems. Put your trust in the Lord and in our brotherly devotion. Please continue watching to find out more.
Man is not forsaken on earth. He is a child of God, engaged in constructive work, temporarily clothed in flesh. He is a student in a meritorious school, where he must learn to raise himself up. The human struggle is his opportunity, his set of tools and his textbook. How childish to imagine that the mere ringing down of the curtain would settle transcendental questions of the infinite. One life is but a single act, one body a garment, one century a day, one task an experience, one triumph an acquisition, one death a breath of renovation. How many lives, how many bodies, how many centuries, how many tasks, how many triumphs, how many deaths are still allotted to us? These astounding messages from the spirits via a human medium convey the message of Spiritism. Spiritism emerged in the mid-19th century through the findings and philosophy of French educator Hippolyte Léon Denisard Rivail, also known as Allan Kardec. Contemporaries of Allan Kardec included Spiritist philosophers Léon Denis and renowned author Arthur Conan Doyle. Spiritism followers explore the nature, origin, and destiny of souls, often through afterlife communication, conveyed via a medium. Throughout Latin America and parts of Europe, Spiritism is known and practiced by millions of people. Numerous books have been written that provide insights into the afterlife and the soul's immortality. One such volume is Nosolar, or The Astral City by Spirit André Luis through Spiritist medium Francisco Cândido Xavier. Francisco Cândido Xavier was a well-known Brazilian philanthropist who co-authored more than 400 books. In The Astral City, former medical doctor André Luis speaks from the afterlife of his awakening and healing within a spiritual society near the Earth's surface. This story describes not only the continuation of life beyond the physical body, but more importantly, how heaven cares for each and every human soul. The following excerpt from The Astral City describes how André Luis was strengthened spiritually upon his rescue from the lower zones. Chapter 4. The Spirit Doctor. I awoke the following day after a deep, refreshing sleep. A comforting light poured through my window, bathing everything in the room with radiance and filling my heart with hope. I felt like a new man, filled with renewed energy and the joy of living. Only one thing clouded my soul. I longed for my home and for my family so far away. Numerous questions troubled my mind, but my feeling of relief was so great that it calmed my spirit and kept me from further contemplation. I wanted to get up and enjoy the beauty of my surroundings, but I could not. I realized that without the magnetic cooperation of my attendant, I would not be able to leave my bed. I had scarcely gotten over the many experiences when the door opened and Clarence entered, accompanied by a friendly stranger. They greeted me cordially, wishing me peace. My rescuer from the lower zones asked about my general health, and my attendant quickly came to inform him. Clarence smiled and introduced his companion, Brother Henry de Luna, of the medical staff of the spiritual colony. Brother Henry was dressed in white, and his face radiated benevolence. He examined me at length, then smiled and spoke. It is a pity that you've come here by way of suicide. Clarence remained calm, but I felt a surge of revolt within me. Suicide? I remembered the accusations of those perverse beings in the lower zones. even though I was grateful to my benefactors, I couldn't accept this accusation. I believe you are mistaken, I said, distressed. My departure from the world had other causes. I fought over 40 days trying to overcome death. I suffered through 2 serious operations because of an intestinal occlusion. Quite so, the doctor continued, calm and perfectly composed. But the occlusion was the result of very serious causes. Perhaps you haven't thought it over enough. The spirit body presents within it a complete history of the actions practiced on Earth. Leaning over me, he went on, pointing to different parts of my body. Let's look at the intestinal zone, he said. The occlusion was due to cancerous elements, which in turn arose from some indiscretions of yours, in which you contracted syphilis. The disease might not have assumed such grave characteristics had your mental attitudes been firmly based on the principles of moderation and brotherly love. Instead, you chose a dark, exasperating way of life, which attracted destructive vibrations from those around you. You never imagined that anger attracts negative forces, did you? Your lack of self-control and your thoughtlessness in dealing with others, whom you so often unthinkingly offended, frequently left you under the influence of sickly and inferior beings. These circumstances greatly aggravated your physical state. After a long pause, in which he went on examining me attentively, he continued. Have you observed, my friend, that your liver was damaged through your action? That your kidneys were also mistreated in your reckless disregard for the divine gift of physical existence? I felt deeply disappointed, but the doctor, seemingly unaware of my anguish, continued to clarify. The bodily organs possess incalculable reserves in accordance with the Lord's designs. You, my friend, evaded many excellent opportunities and wasted the precious blessing of physical existence. The long-term assignment which you had been given by those of greater spiritual accomplishment was reduced to half-hearted attempts at work which you never completed. Your entire gastronomical system was destroyed as a direct result of your harmless excesses in food and drink, and your essential energies were devoured by the syphilis you contracted through still other excesses. As we see, the diagnosis is incontestable. I thought about problems of human life and reflected on the many opportunities I had lost. In my life on Earth, I had owned many masks, tailoring them to the situation at hand. I had never imagined I would be asked to account for those seemingly unimportant episodes. I had at that time conceived of human error according to human laws. Everything not prohibited by those laws was natural and acceptable. Here, however, I found another system of judging those errors. I was not confronted by stern judges pronouncing harsh verdicts or facing torture or the infernal abyss. Instead, smiling benefactors commented on my weaknesses as if they were dealing with a wayward child. Their superior compassion struck a blow in my human pride. If only I had been tormented by diabolic beings, I would have found my failure less bitter. Clarence's sympathetic kindness, the doctor's warm tone, and the attendant's good-natured patience all served to turn my pride to shame. I covered my face with my hands and sobbed brokenheartedly, realizing that Henry de Luna's conclusions were irrefutable. I admitted the full extent of my faults. Only one torturing truth now remained before me. I had truly committed suicide. I had wasted the precious opportunity of human life, and was nothing more than a castaway rescued by charity. It was then that Clarence, stroking my hair in a fatherly manner, spoke. Stop lamenting, my son. I went in search of you in answer to the intercessions of those who love you in the higher spheres. Your tears will grieve their hearts. Surely you would rather show your gratitude by remaining calm during the examination of your faults, wouldn't you? True, your diagnosis points clearly to suicide, but I assure you that hundreds of others leave the earth daily in exactly the same way you did. Therefore, still your heart. Use the treasure of repentance well. Keep the blessing of remorse in your soul, however late it has arrived. Don't forget that worrying doesn't solve our problems. Put your trust in the Lord and in our brotherly devotion. Rest your troubled heart, for many of us have already gone the same way as you. At these generous words, I rested my head against his shoulder and wept. Enlightened viewers, it's been a pleasure to have your company on today's Selections from the Astral City, Chapter 4, The Spirit Doctor, on Words of Wisdom.